Thank you for joining me on the Meg Ellefson Show. I appreciate you tuning in, as always. My guest this morning from Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce, Wisconsin's Chamber of Commerce, actually, Scott Manley. How are you?
Good morning, Meg. I'm doing very well, thanks.
Despite, and I know, relatively speaking, you're doing very well, but as we were chatting off air, it's really concerning what we are going to be facing here in Wisconsin with the antics of those on the left, Democrats. And let's start by you shared with me, I guess the concerns that you expressed in your tweet this morning, and let's talk about what Democrats are trying to pull with regard to our last elections here in Wisconsin.
Yeah, so, and I think, Meg, that a lot of people don't realize this, that they think that the lawsuit that was filed last week is just about the redistricting maps, but it's actually quite a bit more than that. What these Democrats are asking for in their lawsuit is for the overturning of 17 senators who were elected last fall, to have their elections overturned by the court and have them removed from their offices. And they do that under what is a pretty obscure statute in Wisconsin law called a writ of quo warranto. And a writ of quo warranto is used by a court to move somebody who has illegally usurped somebody else's office, somebody else's elected office. And so they're asking the Wisconsin Supreme Court to issue writs of quo warranto against all 17 senators who were elected last fall and remove them from their office, which would put us into a constitutional crisis, Meg, because the state Senate has 33 members. And if the court were to do what the Democrats are asking, which is to remove 17 of them, they would only have 16. They wouldn't even have enough for a quorum to conduct the people's business. And of course, the partisan makeup is you know what really stinks here and makes it obvious what they're trying to do. Last fall, out of the 17 senators who were elected, there were 12 of them who were Republicans and 5 of them who were Democrats. So it would remove more than half of the Republican doing so. If the court agreed to what the Democrats are asking them to do, they would be removing with the stroke of a pen more than half of the Republicans serving in the Republican majority in the state Senate. So this is really banana republic level stuff we're talking about here. This is what the liberal majority on the Wisconsin Supreme Court is going to be asked to do. And I would note for you, Meg, that Wausau and your listeners are in the 29th Senate District, which is currently represented by State Senator Corey Tomchek, just an amazing guy, great senator, great advocate for the area. He would be removed from office, would be subject to being fined under a writ of quo warranto for illegally usurping somebody's office, and he could be made to pay the legal fees of the Democrats who have hired the Harvard Law Center and other Washington, D.C.-based law firms to overturn these elections. So it's really crazy stuff here, and I'm actually find it shocking that the mainstream media in the state is not reporting on it, because it's whatever they think Donald Trump did relative to the 2020 election. What the Democrats are proposing to do with these state senators is the 2020 election on steroids.
I don't even know how to respond, Scott. I mean, I'm just, frankly, it's kind of overwhelming and discouraging, because this is what I was trying to communicate during the, during the 2022 campaign. And I mean, the bottom line is that primary candidates matter. And I'm hoping that people now can learn this lesson, that we need to be very careful, very selective about picking the right candidate to go against the Democrat in the general election. And if we do not, then we are going to be facing what we are facing. And that, and I mean, I'm just, I referred to it, and I never anticipated it would get this bad, but I referred to prior to Janet, the Janet Court being assembled, I referred to it as the calm before the storm. Well, this is a tsunami that is hitting Wisconsin, and conservatives should be very, very concerned.
Yeah, I think it's appalling, and I think it's unprecedented. I'm not aware of a single point in the history of our state where somebody has asked a court to remove every single person elected in the previous election. I mean, that's if for no reason other than they didn't like the outcome and they want to remove a majority of Republican senators from serving in that body, despite the fact that the good people of those 17 districts elected them all. I mean, it's just truly bizarre.
Well, and you know, this isn't something that was just carelessly dropped on the state of Wisconsin. You know that they have been planning and scheming ever since Janet Protasiewicz was elected, and or probably even longer. They've been planning this. You know, I somehow end up on these various Democrat email lists, and I have been following this. You know, I'm not thrilled when I get an email, but there's a group, and I'm trying to think. I don't have the email in front of me, but it's like Hold the Line or something. Some group that I know Eric Holder is a part of, but they have been pushing this maps narrative, this gerrymandering maps narrative throughout the country for quite some time. So this is calculated. This is deliberate. This is something that we are, well, and I would hope that we have some intelligent attorneys that are investigating this right now and looking at this very closely to determine what we can do to defend all of our elected state senators in Wisconsin.
Well, you know, Meg, I don't often have many good things to say about Josh Call, but I want to give him credit because these out-of-state Washington, D.C. based law firms that are filing this lawsuit, before they filed it, they actually petitioned Josh Call to issue these writs of quo warranto against these 17 senators and remove them from office, and he rejected that request and said, "I'm not going to do it."
Maybe it was all a big plan, though, to make him. Who knows? You know, I'm very cynical at this point, Scott.
Well, I think that you're not the only one. I think there's a lot of people who are, and I think that there's probably a good reason that they are. I think that the good people of Wausau, who elected Corey Tomchek to be their state senator, have a right to his representation for 4 years. I mean, that's the way our system works. And what these Democrats are asking the Supreme Court to do is say, nope, you don't get to serve your four-year term. We want to use this obscure law to ask the court to overturn your election. And that's just crazy.
Well, and I mean, I guess when you bring up the point about the mainstream media not covering this, I suppose they're waiting for their marching orders or their marketing campaign of Democrats to see that what the prescribed narrative is going to be, how they can explain this to the low information voters. Because, I mean, so, okay, let's remove here in the 29th district, let's remove Corey Tomchek from office. So then who's going to represent us then? I mean,
no one.
Right.
You'll have no representation.
Yeah.
Until they're asking for special elections for all of those 17 senators to occur in the fall of 2024. So, and then they wouldn't be sworn in until January of 2025. So you'd effectively be going, probably at least a year without any representation at all. Talk about disenfranchising voters. I mean, it's just that, Meg, it's just absolutely Looney Tunes. Mm-hmm. It's crazy.
Insanity. Well, and I did manage to dig up this this email. So this organization, and you referenced this. This is an out-of-state. This is someone, you know, I presume, as you referenced, Washington, D.C. organization. This National Redistricting Action Fund. And I mean, I get a lot of emails from them, and I debate sometimes when I see it. It aggravates me, and I think, no, I got to keep an eye on it. But here's the latest one that I received from them. They're also targeting Ohio. I mean, there is none of this is by accident. They are, hey, what do Ohio and Wisconsin have in common? Swing states, right? I mean, this is all to create chaos for the upcoming presidential election and to take Wisconsin Republicans' eye off of the presidential election and be instead distracted by what's going on with this, removal of all of these Republican state senators.
And five Democrats, too.
Yeah, well, but I'm sure
12,
they can sacrifice.
12 Republicans and five Democrats. As we sit here today, there's 22 Republicans and 11 Democrats in the Senate, and this would remove 12 of the 22 Republicans.
Well, and the five Democrats that you mentioned, they've probably been promised something. If they lose their seat, there's something else for them in play, so that I'm sure they're all on board with this. I mean, that's just how they roll. So. It's so new, it's so fresh, I guess. Have you spoken with attorneys? I mean, I guess I'm going to reach out to Rick Essenberg from Will. I guess that will be where I'll start. But is there anybody else that you have had a conversation with that has anything optimistic to say about these actions?
Well, I haven't had a chance to talk to any attorneys about it, but I have a feeling that the 17 senators who would be removed from their office and be facing legal fees and fines are probably looking to talk to attorneys right now. I certainly would be if I were them.
It's just, well, and again, I know it probably upsets people for me to hear me say this again, but elections truly do have consequences, and I'm not just talking general elections. We have to be better about choosing a viable candidate, because that and being strategic about primary candidates in the future, that has got to be the lesson that is to be learned. I mean, we perhaps would not have even been having these conversations if we had, well, I know we wouldn't if we had a Republican governor and a conservative majority on the state Supreme Court. Well, before we run out of time, Scott, I'd like, not really, but we will. I don't want to talk about any more bad news, but we have to, because Governor Evers has vetoed a number of pro-consumer energy bills. I'm sure that some have heard about this, and it's happened in other states. I think New York has outright banned natural gas appliances. And, you know, when there were those that were saying, when scoffing at the early reports that this is what the left was going to target next, it's potentially going to happen even here in Wisconsin. And someday, perhaps we won't even have the ability to drive our gas-powered vehicles anymore because of these laws that are limiting our freedom to choose the type of vehicle we want to drive.
Yeah, and you're right, Megan. Some of them, like the New York example, these are state laws, but in many cases, we're seeing local governments who are banning gas-powered lawnmowers, gas-powered leaf blowers, gas-powered, natural gas-powered appliances like cooktop stoves and so forth. And what these bills would have done is said, hey, you, the consumer, you have a right to choose the appliance or the vehicle, the snowmobile, the snowblower, the Mercury Marine outboard motor, the personal watercraft, you name it, if it's an engine or an appliance that runs on fuel, you have the right to buy a gas or a natural gas powered appliance or outdoor equipment. And the state or local government can't tell you that you can't. They can't tell you that you have to have an electric snowblower, or you can't have an electric leaf blower, or you have to, or that you have to have an electric snowblower, or you have to have an electric boat motor. So it was just, as you said, very, very pro-consumer, very much, you know, protecting people's right to choose the product that they think is best for them, instead of having the heavy hand of government dictating to them. And that was a bridge too far for Tony Evers. He said, absolutely not. We're going to, if the state or local governments want to ban gasoline-powered snowblowers or snowmobiles or boats or cars or motorcycles, then we ought to be able to do that. And I just find that profoundly anti-liberty and profoundly anti-consumer, and very much a command and control government knows best mentality that I think is wrong for our state.
You know, and if there are those listening that don't think that it's going to happen, look at the incandescent light bulb. I mean, it took a while, but it's banned now in the United States of America. So, and I mean, that's just one example. And I mean, imagine how expensive it's going to be for, and I mean, this is going to affect, well, it's going to affect poor and the middle class, because, I mean, how many people are going to want to have to go out and buy all new electric whatever, appliances or electric mowers or electric snowblowers or what, you know, whatever it is.
Electric water heater.
Yeah. Well, what about the tourism industry up north? How are they going to be affected if the gas-powered, is there such a thing as an electric boat? I mean, I know that they have trolling motors, but I mean, what will that do? Snowmobiles. I mean, think of all of how our lives will be affected by this here in Wisconsin because of the actions of Tony Evers, who does not care about the citizens here in Wisconsin. It infuriates me that he still makes his trips up to Wausau because he loves our mayor, and he seems to think that he's popular enough up here to show his face. But let me tell you, Scott, if I get the opportunity to give him an earful, I will. So let's briefly, before we run out of time, talk about the other, there were three bills, AB 141, 142, and 49. Is there anything specific about each one that our listeners should be aware of?
Yeah, well, one of them, and we talked quite a bit about this, was the one that says, look, you get consumer choice in your boats and your lawnmowers and snowblowers and snowmobiles,
right?
And so forth. The other one said that a local government or the state can't prohibit you from using natural gas appliances in your home, like a natural gas water heater or a natural gas dryer, clothes dryer, or a natural gas cooktop. He vetoed that one as well. And then the third one would have said that the government can't prohibit the sale of a gasoline-powered vehicle, so things like a car or a truck or a motorcycle, and he vetoed that as well. And so it's just sort of fascinating to me that in the state that makes Harley-Davidsons, that makes Aaron's snowblowers, that makes, you know, Mercury Marine outboard engines, the by far the most used outboard motor on boats in America, that we have a governor that says, no, I don't want to make sure that citizens continue to have access to those products. We want the government to dictate what you're going to be able to buy. It's just so anti-choice and anti-consumer.
Hey, Wisconsin, are you feeling enough pain yet? I certainly hope so. You know, this reminds me, as we've been talking, Scott Manley from WMC, I was thinking of the Winston Churchill quote. It's, and I mean, this is socialism, or I mean, I guess you could argue Marxism. Socialism is a philosophy of failure, the creed of ignorance, and the gospel of envy. Its inherent virtue is the equal sharing of misery. In my opinion, I'm just going to be straight up because I'm so infuriated. If you vote for a Democrat, you are voting for misery. That is what you will get when you vote for Democrats in Wisconsin. It's Scott, I don't know if there's anything, an upside to any of this, if there's any way, glimmer of hope that we have, although I know that this is new, this is fresh, and I guess we will see based on, I mean, you know, Democrats have been planning this. They all along, this is what they, there's no coincidences in any of this. And the timing of this, of course, coincides with the new Janet Court here in Wisconsin.
They filed this lawsuit within 24 hours of her being sworn into office. It's very clearly just raw political aggression. That's what this is.
Well, and it's a pattern that I would imagine will be established throughout the country and the swing states. Ohio, they're going after Ohio again. The exact same thing. And I mean, this is probably just a template for what they are going to try to attempt to do in the other swing states throughout the country. Well, Scott Manley, thank you so much. Well, thanks for the good news. Just kidding. But
don't shoot the messenger.
Right. I know. I do appreciate you joining me this morning to alert our listeners and to educate them and inform them on what's going on. We need to be made aware of this so that we can be prepared to fight back. So we'll keep up the great work. Scott, what's your website? WMC.org, right?
WMC.org.
Okay.
You bet.
Well, thanks again. I appreciate your time this morning. Have a great day.
You as well, Meg. Thanks for having me on.
Thank you.